Some people think the beer you bring says a lot.
I like to try to always just get that opening screen and hear that music. What do you think, Revan? Do you like it? Welcome, Baggables. Excellent to see you. Lanstus, thank you for joining. I know you wouldn't miss it, buddy. So I meant to... Oh, hello everyone, this is the Bomb Bowman, and welcome to my Let's Play of Morrowind. This is part 7. You believe it? Part 7? This is great. There's one thing that's actually been bothering me. Let me fix one thing. So, since the other night... Hold on, that's really loud. Hold on. There we go. Okay. Great. Since the other night, it's been bothering me that I actually forgot something in the cave. They really give you very little time to get through that door, don't they? Can't see my chat. There's my chat. Seven out of a billion. Yeah, I know. This is going to take a while, especially with Tribunal and Blood Moon. Hey, guys. What's the over-under on how many episodes it takes me to finish the whole game with both DLCs? I'm going to get... If I had to guess, I would... 80. Welcome, Spectre Studio. Right, so down here, I actually forgot one thing. And Spectre says that Oblivion had the best music. I agree, and it actually, the weirdest thing, hold on, let me find the thing I want first. There was like a dwarven spear that was worth, it's like a stupid amount of gold. I thought it was right over here. Jeez, she scared the hell out of me just then. Old Deadeyes is back. I saw a dwarven spear. I thought it was right over there. So one thing that I noticed is, like, I obviously played Oblivion a ton, and I was playing Skyrim, and I never noticed that they had the same, like, basic theme music. And then when I heard the theme song for Morrowind for the very first time, something about it was so familiar, and I couldn't put my finger on it. And it wasn't until I really thought about it that I realized they all had the same theme. Yes, Revan, you know, it's funny. I have been wanting to stream Tor, because I'm just obsessed with Tor, but I've heard from pretty much everyone in the chat right now, stream Morrowind instead. So that's what I'm doing. And that's just fine by me. I spent a lot of the day today watching the Lance just knows who it is. It's something. It's like OWS Guild on YouTube. Give tips and tricks. I watched them all today when I was at work. I listen with headphones while I'm actually doing work. I don't know where that spear was. That dwarven spear. Right, the Evenhawk server, right. The OWS Guild or whatever is... That's Harbinger. And that is where Lance's plays. OWS Guild thing. Are you in the OWS Guild, Lances? Because if so, I obviously want to be in that guild for my characters on Harbinger. I have characters on Evenhawk as well. Cobra. All of my favorite regulars are here. Guys, I want to just, without getting weird, thank you so much. That's all I wanted to say. I really appreciate you coming to join the stream. It is so great. I've only been doing this for like a week and a half. It is so great to actually have like a couple regulars who I know and I'm excited to see. You know what I mean? It's really the best, it's the best part. You know what? Excuse my language. Fuck the spear. Let's go do some other quests. No one wants to watch me look for a spear for half an hour. I thought it was right up against that door as I came in. Okay. I don't know the guy's actual name. But OWS Guild, like the guy who does all the videos on YouTube, he was saying that the whole point of their guild, I guess, was to have just an absolutely overwhelming number of members. And he confirmed that there's no requirement to join, which is the only reason that I thought I could get in. Oh, come on, jump. There you go. Oh, there's the spear. We found it. Look at this. Look at this thing. Value 300, weight 14. So I'm obviously not leaving without that. Yeah, Cobra, it's late for you. Does it sound like I'm yelling? Sorry. I feel the need to project. Bagables, I have been good. I'm not feeling great today, but I think it's just the weather. But you want to see struggling? Well, I already found the spear. So there'll be no more struggling today. Now I just have to find the exit, which I think is right there. I don't know if you... I don't know who was here the other night, but there was someone... it was like J-Dubs or something. I'm trying to remember what his name was. I'd have to look it up, but he was one of the voice actors from... I just gotta find the way out. From Skywind. And he was just, when I first came in here, he was like, what's the over-under on how long it takes this guy to find the Dwemer puzzle cube? And I'm like, I'll find it in 5 minutes. And I think it took me like 2 hours to find. Whoa, what in the world? Oh. Alright, thank you for killing that thing for me. Okay, so let's check the journal. Okay, let's go back to Hasfat and Tobalus. Belmora Fighters Guild, right, that's where we have to go. Back to the Belmora Fighters Guild. Which I kinda wanna go. Oh yeah, we're not far at all, are we? I kinda wanna go like southwest, I guess. Who's dying to find out what Cobra Laserface found in his closet that he thinks I might be interested in? The Morrowind Prophecy, the official guide to the Elder Scrolls III Morrowind. Hang on to that. I think if I'm not mistaken, Bethesda produced that internally. They didn't go to, what's the big name of that, of the Brady Games, the strategy guide people? They produced that completely in-house. So that is a really cool thing to have. Spectre says Starforge. Yeah, from Bethesda. That's really cool, Cobra. That's something that I was debating going on eBay trying to find. If you had the map, I would say, you know, have it matted and framed, because that'd be a really nice thing to hang up. Do you remember how you got it, Cobra? Lance says, I don't think that was it. I just get to the top of this hill, I get back to the Fighters Guild, and we are off to the races on the main quest line. And isn't it so great that there's like no loading screen? Look at this. I just climbed the wall and here I am. Okay, who wants me to murder the drunk? Right. Yeah, I remember vividly, this is not that great of a story, but seeing Morrowind, like, used at Electronics Boutique for, like, I don't know, like $5 or whatever, and I had just gotten done playing Oblivion for the first time, and I remember seeing Morrowind, and I was like, oh, the graphics won't be as good, I'm gonna skip it. Revan wanted me to kill the guy so bad. Big chat delay tonight too. That was a couple minutes ago. All right. Cobra, what would a good reason to kill him be though? He's drunk in public. These guards would kill me for picking up a cup. So, I'm just saying.
Speak, traveler.
I think part of the reason I'm yelling is because these headphones, my good pair broke, so I'm using this as my backup pair, and they cup on my ear, like, really tight, so when I put it on, I can't hear my own voice at all. It's like a cone of silence.
Oh. Quickly, Outlander. I haven't much time.
What is this about?
Water kills. What's up, water?
Stand about. Get moving.
What is that? Oh, the temple. Right. I'm gonna go to the temple real quick because I think I've got like blight or something. I'm gonna go pay to get cleansed. It's kind of like going to your doctor for penicillin. Disease, no disease. I'm sure I have a blight, though. I'm not affected with a blight? I thought I caught something in the swamp. Huh. Absolutely baggables. It makes the game so much more fun to share with you guys. I'm not trying to get mushy. I thought for sure I had blight or something. I was in the swamp at one point, and I could have sworn a little dialogue box popped up that said, like, oh, you've contracted... I don't know. To rule an army? Yeah, I wouldn't know, Revan. Right. Gotcha. I would just use... I've got, like Apple earbuds I could use. Because I'm using... I've got a blue snowball on my desk. I'm not even using this mic up here. Got a little mixed up. Yeah, just keep walking straight. Next thing I've got my eye on, specifically for Tor, is a new mouse. I saw the one, I'm trying to get what the name of it was. Naga, I want to get a Naga, and the one with all the buttons on the side. I like the look of that. I think that'll make me a little bit more successful in the war zones. If I can get to my, you know, all my abilities a little bit quicker. A lot of diseases, very few blights. Good to know. I should be a vampire, huh? What if I don't want to be a vampire?
Watch your step.
Speak freely, friend.
Okay, I got your damn Dwemer puzzle cube. Should get Star Wars Empire at War. So, have you done a little favor, I asked? Perfect! Just what I was looking for, a Dwemer Rubik's Cube. Just let me take this Dwemer puzzle box, and then I'll tell you what Caius will want to know about the Sixth House and about the Nerevarine.
Spoiler alert, it's me!
By the way, the inscriptions on the box seem to be directions for setting a Dwemer key to open a specific lock. Interesting. If you're interested, I just said it was interesting. After you've delivered your report to Caius, come back, and maybe I'll have a key you can take back to Arkenthod. Oh, there was that door I couldn't open. Interesting. Daddy Shimura, good to see you. Welcome back. Alright, so let's go back to Caius. Let's ask him about the disappearance of the dwarves. Let's see what he has to say about that. The disappearance of the dwarves predates Imperial written records. Dunmer Oral accounts Dunmer Oral accounts record that the Dwemer were utterly destroyed by the gods for profane practices and impiety. Dwarven ruins are scattered across Tamriel, and weapons, armor, housewares, coins, and other items of Dwemer design are often found. But the circumstances surrounding the disappearance of the dwarves remains one of Tamriel's greatest mysteries. Mm-hmm. Let's see. So let's ask him about the Nerevarine. The Nerevarine. The Ashlanders believe a reborn Nerevar will unite the Dunmer against the Outlander invaders and restore the ancient Dark Elven nation. Nerevar is a legendary hero and saint of the temple, but the temple denies the prophecy and persecutes heretics who believe in the Nerevarine. Tell Caius that Sharn Gra Muzgob would be a better person to ask about the native faiths and superstition. Interesting. What about the Sixth House? Great. House Dagoth is the Sixth House, the lost Sixth House. In the First Age, House Dagoth betrayed the other great houses during the War of the First Council and was destroyed for their treason. I can answer any questions you have, but I'll also give you some notes to give to Caius and recommend some Sixth House references he should read. What kind of references? Here's a list of books. All of them will tell you something about the Sixth House and how it ended. The War of the First Council, Saint Nerevar, Nerevar Moon and Star, and the Real Nerevar. Is that like the real Baron Zaya? Good luck finding them, though. The recent events have made these hard to come by. Ooh, I want to find all the books. Probably not easy. Dead Ishimura. Did I say welcome back? Welcome back, Dead Ishimura, if I didn't say that. Yeah, you're right. I mean, it's like I don't want to read all the books, like, and make you, and ask you to watch me read books, but I do want to get as much lore as I can. That's the main reason I wanted to play this game, was for the story, like, obviously. You know, it wasn't for the thrilling combat. House Dagoth was the sixth of the seven Dunmer Great Houses. Okay. Nothing remains of the sixth house. Its members were all slain or adopted into other great houses following their treason in the War of the First Council. Okay. Their clansted was called Kagorun. Interesting. Okay. House Dagoth? They already clicked that one. Dunmer Puzzle Box? Okay. You want to play Stellaris on max difficulty? Lancis, if you do it, if you stream it, I will be first. I'll be in the first row. I'll be ready to go. And no stabbing people, Vagables. Okay. All right, great. I better get back to Caius Cassay. Thank you, Hasfat. Flania? Out of the way, you. You, Sawit! Oh, God, get away from the door. God!
I could kill that girl.
Get my rested bonus, right? Uh-oh. What happened? What's happening?
Omnipotent. Omniscient. Sovereign. Immutable. How sweet it is to be a god.
Cobra, I'm scared. What was that? That wasn't very fun. Was that... My guess is that's Dagoth talking to me. Let's check my journal. I had a disturbing dream. I can only recall one part. A tall figure with a golden mask led me among the dead, as through a wedding celebration. I heard many voices, but no lips moved. I strained to breathe, but my chest didn't move. The tall figure spoke with each figure as he passed among them, laughing and joking, as if they were alive. He said, "Omnipotent, omniscient, sovereign, immutable. How sweet it is to be a god." I tried to cry out, but without breath, my tongue fluttered in vain. Wow. It was my comp, yeah, right? Embrace the fear. Use it to make you stronger. I will, Dead Ishimura. Wow. Okay. Oh, Jesus. Could you just... You see what I'm dealing with? I guess I'll leave the room. I mean, do I need that? Do I need that? Ah. Jesus. That was more terrifying than the dream. You stay in there. Jesus.
Can you ask your question quickly? I must be
good. Let's get back to Caius Cassay. Dead Eyes with the jump scare. I know. She is super creepy. And look, she blocks everywhere I want to go. I mean, I will say this. I was described the other day as a glass cannon because I die pretty quickly, but I guess the bound bow is a little OP, so it hits hard. But, she has basically been an adequate tank, is what I'm driving at. Caius Cassay lives right here, right? No, wait. Oh, there he is. Okay, straight across. Okay, so across the bridge. Turn around, take a right, across the bridge, walk straight. Okay. Dead Ishimura, what is up with you? What is new? What are you playing these days? A tank that watches you sleep, I know.
You like to walk a fine line.
Say your words.
Oh, he's right there, right? Okay. Jesus.
How can I help you?
You can put a shirt on, for one. Are you here to discuss your orders, Cerethiel, or is there something else you want? Oh, bangables. Let's see. Hasfat Antibalus. Yeah. Let's see. Nerevarine? Yeah, Nerevarine Prophecies. Sixth House? Your orders? Oh, okay, so he did take the notes. These notes are from Hasfat Antibalus? Excellent. I trust he didn't work you too hard for them. I'll look them over in more detail later, but now I have some new orders for you. Oh my. Dude's got pizza nipples? I didn't need to know that. Dark Souls 3, Dead Ishimura? The new free PS Plus games? Oh, yeah. Dark Souls 3. I have not got into the Dark Souls series yet. That is absolutely on my list, though. Let's see some new orders. I've glanced at Hasfat Antibalus' notes. They cover the Sixth House admirably, but not the Nerevarine cult. Hop on over to the... Why don't you hop on over, Pizza Nipples, to the Balmora Mages Guild. It's right... I know where it is. Thank you. Get Sharn Gramuzgob to tell you what she knows about the Nerevarine. She'll have some silly errand for you. Of course she does. She can't just tell me. We gotta go fetch her, like, 10 herbs or something. Do what she asks and report back when she's giving you the information. Okay. She knows your every thought. You should definitely be scared. God, I can't stop like looking at his nipples now, and I don't want to. It's making me uncomfortable. You know, I was just at the Fighter's Guild. Now I gotta go all the way back over there. I just impressed myself that I made it here without having to open up the map and, you know, dig into it a little bit. Herbs, don't you wish that's what you have to fetch? Yeah, I do. The girl from the movie The Grudge? Yeah, a little bit. A little bit, you know? Oof. I'm pretty sure the orc is downstairs. Yeah, this is her. Sharn Gramuzgob.
Citizen.
Citizen, don't you mean Outlander? Let's see. Oh, you're one of Caius's associates. That is a... Though that's a horse of a different color. Caius and I have a very Let's have her talk like this. Caius and I have a very satisfactory arrangement, see? And I'm sure we can come to some sort of arrangement. If you will complete a little errand for me? Sure. The errand then is very simple. I need the skull of Levul Andrano. I need the skull of Levul Andrano. You'll find it in Andrano Ancestral Tomb. I know where that is. But take care not to upset the natives. The Dunmer have some peculiar primitive prejudices. Say that 5 times real quick. Peculiar primitive prejudices. Peculiar primitive prejudices. I'm not doing it anymore. Against necromancy. And take grave objection to unauthorized tomb visits. Well, call me Lara Croft, because we are going to go raid that tomb. Let's do it. While I'm here, I need some spells. I need some new spells. Let's see. Now, I've heard a rumor that if I cast Feather on myself, I'll be able to run faster. Fifth barrier. That's cool. Calm creature. I need more spells is what I need. Restoration, resist fire. Yeah, the resist spells are good. Dispel. Yeah. Cure common disease on other. Cure poison. Weapon resistance. I think I want to get feather. Jump higher as well. Yeah, I'm going to get strong feather for right now and play with that a little bit, because one of my main... Yeah. Take this old short sword. Maybe these old scrolls will come in handy. Cool. Fireblade. If it's a short sword... Is it a short sword? Goodbye. One of my main... Yeah, alteration is a minor skill, so I definitely want to be using some of it. I want to know what's... Is my sneak red because... Is it being, like, messed with, or I just don't have... Is it being, like, debuffed? That's kind of what I want to know. Is it because, it's because of my armor, maybe? Okay. Oh, this spell only lasts 10 seconds? Okay. Yeah, I want to make my own spells. I know that. Before I leave, why don't I try to sell some stuff? Because I am... I'm walking really slow. I know I was sneaking, but like even like regular. The errand. Let's barter. What do you buy? Magic stuff probably only? Yeah. Try switching to a melee weapon? Okay. Scroll of Vitality, restore health. Oh, that's cool. I'll hang on to that. I don't see myself using like lightning shield or fire shield. Fortify speed would be good just if I'm running somewhere. Frost shield, invisibility, I'll hang on to. Fire damage. I'm not going to use that. It's just not my style. Restore personality would be good if I'm trying to sweet talk someone. Vintage brandy. She only has... Yeah, she doesn't have enough gold for that. I'll hang on to it. I might just drink it. And let's go up one. I believe that was one of Cobra's pro tips. Do I think she has pizza nipples?
May your battle show only victory, friend.
Let's see. What do I have for a melee weapon now? Hey, oh, fire blade. It's a short blade. Nice. I will actually use this. Check that out. Sneak is down to 10 now. Put the sword away. It's back up to 20. It's gonna have something to do with my armor. I don't know. Boots, maybe? Like, this chest is supposed to, like, replenish itself, too. Okay, I totally forgot where I was just gonna go. Okay, Andrano Ancestral Tomb, right? This tomb is south of Pelagiad, just off the road. Yeah. Let me take a quick look at my map. My sneak is damaged. Yeah, I think so. That was it right there. No.
Yes, Outlander.
I'll just head to Pelagiad and take it from there. Oh, just for the hell of it. Take off my boots. No, that didn't help. Let's try that strong feather spell a little bit. just purely to try to boost my alteration a bit. You know, it might be too like high level of a spell because it's strong feather. Yeah, it's eating through my magicka like anything. Wow. Oh, look at that. Chance zero. Yeah. Can't even use that. I should have checked that out. I need to level my alteration in a smaller way. I need to get a small alteration spell, like an easy one with a higher cast chance. Oh, was it 20? Okay, Cobra, I'm sorry. Good call. Wow, did you see my magicka just, like, go nuts? That's Caldera, Balmora, Pelagia this way, right. Yeah, you're right. 20%. So I could still kind of just keep spamming it to, oh, what's that other one I have to? Open Door? 33%? Yeah, okay. I could find a, like, really powerful... not powerful, but a strong lock, and just keep like spamming it on the lock just to, I don't know. I'm not sure if it probably doesn't work that way. It probably only works when it's successful. Ah. Look at this friendly-looking forest. Cool. Roasted rat. Let's see. Pelagia, this away. Out of the way, Deadeyes. Hey, it worked. It doesn't look like a tomb, but I just want to see what this is. Oh yeah, I've been there before. So glad to be back on the main quest line, too. Oh, hey, I was Revan. I was wondering what happened to you. You hadn't asked me to kill anyone in like 10 minutes. I was becoming worried that, I don't know, you were sick or something. Pelagiad and Vivek. Wow. This ship? What ship, Revan? Did we lose water kills? Are you still here? I had a question. Here we go. Is this Pelagiad? Named doubtlessly for Pelagius the Mad. Let's see. You're on a cruise ship, Revan? Is that right? Oh, hey, Water. You didn't tell me what are you playing right now? What other than Morrowind, what kind of stuff are you into? You an Elder Scrolls nut like me, or what other stuff are you into? I can't believe you're on a cruise ship right now. That's awesome. Like the Caribbean, or what? Okay, let's check our journal. Okay. South of Pelagia, just off the road, just before the fork where the road goes southwest towards Sedanine and southeast to Vivek. Wow. That's very specific. So let's go south, and then we'll wait for when the road forks. The Bahamas. Oh, great. I went on a cruise once. I went to the Western Caribbean. We went to Grand Cayman and Belize and Cozumel and one other location. I can't remember. What's that? Can I kill it? I want to kill it with my blade. Oh, Revan, look, it's just having a drink of water. It's not bothering anybody. This looks like a screenshot opportunity to me. It's not that great, but let's see. Right now you're playing a total conversion mod for Mountain Blade Warband called Prophecy of Pendor. Interesting. I haven't checked that out yet. Total conversion mod, you say? Oh, Carlos and Charlie's in Cozumel Spectre. Let's see. Is this it? Yes, this is it. Okay, let's do an official save. Because you never know what could happen in there. Oh, crap. Okay, nobody panic. Okay, nobody panic. There's a ghost coming to kill me. Would someone just... Okay, I think I need either silver, right? Or we were debating if the bound bow would actually kill them or not. So for right now, I'm going to take my silver dagger, right? Because the fire, the standard short sword, right? The fire blade is not going to do anything, right? So let's use the silver dagger. Gotta, oh, everybody, we're going to stop for a minute. Revan has to force choke someone. Keep calm and play Morrowind. Ectoplasm? What is that even worth? 10? I guess I'll sell it. What? Oh, what happened to this guy? Jeez. Oh, Dunmer Treasure Hunter? Expensive shoes. Extravagant pants. Look at these pants. They are truly extravagant. Fireblade. Oh, the fireblade will work because it's an enchanted weapon. Got it. Thank you. Makes total sense. I am almost over encumbered. I've got to hit some merchants when I get back to town. Let's save that door. Let's go down this way first. Oh, I hear something creepy. A Jedi tried to stab you? What did you do to the Jedi, Revan? Did you show him mercy? Oh. Crap. Whoops, I just cast Feather. That'll teach him. Oh, did you kill them both? Oh, I didn't even cast my spell. Okay. Here, no, there's another one. You didn't get them both. Whoa, 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 whoa. Look at my health. Good lord. Wow. Okay, I'm going to use Balina's Soothing Balm. You choked him to death, Revan? I thought you'd just choke him a little bit. Just like, you know, like playful. Look, I have one health. And what do we say to death? Not today. This isn't going well at all, is it? There we go. I definitely want to level Restoration. I should have had Restoration as a major skill. Instead of Short Blade, I think. What are you going to do? I like this, Valena's Soothing Balm. It's a very low cost. Revan wants everyone to know that he knows how to kill force ghosts. I am going to back away slowly. Iron shield. Yeah, I have, like, no room to carry anything right now. Viper arrow. Ooh. Viper arrows. Yes, please. And then iron arrows. Longbow. I could carry it, but it's not even worth it. Small chest. Nice gold. I'll take the gold. Oh, and a silver dagger. I'm going to take the silver dagger because the one I'm using Well, the condition's actually not bad on it. I can always sell it. Burn. Bone meal. One of the things that bothered me, speaking of bone meal, was that mission in Skyrim. Oh, jeez. 30, no thanks. Where you've got to find... You're with Serana in her mother's, like, shop. Her, not her shop. Her, laboratory, basically. And you've got to find finely ground bone meal. And I'm just like, I found 100 things of bone meal. And I just wanted to ask her, I'm like, can't we just grind the bone meal? Does it have to already be, like, finely ground for you, Serana? You know, it's funny. I don't remember what I'm doing here. A ghoul heart? Wow, that's expensive. That's good stuff. I played KOTOR. I did not play KOTOR 2. I hope, after saying that, Revan, I hope we are still friends. I hope a lot of us are still friends after that. I'm sure probably a lot of you guys played KOTOR 2. Gotta get a skull. Oh, yeah, that's right, too. That's right, I gotta find a skull. Thank you, Cobra. You probably know exactly where it is, too, right? Oh, KOTOR 2 is a favorite of all time. Yeah, I've gotta play it then, because... I could kill that gore. I mean, the first one... So ruined. The thing that bothered me about the first one was just the, obviously, like, the D&D kind of battling, where you just run up to someone and the dice are rolling and you're just kind of swinging, and it wasn't that active, but you do get used to it, of course. I know you know where it is. Of course you do. Cobra, I would love to see you do, like, a speed run of this game. I bet you could do a decent speed... What the fuck? That's one of the scariest things I've ever seen. Ooh. Wow. Shield, no. Iron saber, no. Look at this. Do you guys see that nonsense? Wow, look at that. That's horrendous. I mean, the clipping alone is just embarrassing, but that is just scary. I'm saving before I'm opening that door. A completionist in ES games? No, I totally am with you. Do you like to 100% things, or are you happy like 99%ing things? Because I'm happy 99%ing things. Or even 95, depending on what it is. Oh, this door looks ominous. I was expecting a boss. Iron dagger. Nah. Ash salts. Yeah, pretty good. Homilies of Blessed Almalexia. Hmm. Wow. That's a little long. It's like I'll skim it and I'll read the whole thing later. Sothisil and the Scribs. Young Sothisil, while playing in the egg mine, saw a number of Scribs in a deep shaft, and he began to cast stones upon them, snickering as they skittered and scattered, until one of the Scribs, lifting its head up in agony, cried out to Sothisil, "Please, please have mercy, little boy, for what is sport to you is suffering and death to us." And so Sothisil discovered that the idol of amusements of one... That's a typo. It should say, Sothisil discovered that the idle amusements of one may be the solemn tortures of another. Lord Vivek and the contentious beasts. A Shalk and a Kagudi were strutting back and forth in a foyada, casting aspersions of one another's looks. "You are the ugliest creature alive," the Shalk told the Kagudi. No, you are the ugliest creature alive. That's my Kaguti voice. The Kaguti told the Shock. For each thought himself more handsome and the other most ugly. Then Lord Vivek chanced by and settled their dispute. No, you both are the ugliest creatures alive, and I will not have my pleasant sojourn spoiled by your unseemly squabbling. So he dealt them both mighty blows, shattering their skulls and silencing their argument, and went merrily upon his way. And thus Lord Vivek proved that ugliness is as much in one's manner as in one's appearance. Ugh. The boiled Kaguti. It is said that if a Kaguti steps into a boiling pool, he will leap out immediately to avoid harm. But if the Kaguti is standing in a pool and a wizard slowly raises the temperature measure by measure to boiling, yeah, just like a frog in a pot. Thus we see that we must be alert not only to the obvious danger, but also to the subtle degrees by which change may result in danger. The dubious healer. Once upon a time, a Telvanni issued forth from his tower and proclaimed to all the world that he was a mighty and learned healer, master of all alchemy and potions, and able to cure all diseases. Lord Vivek looked upon this and dealt him a mighty blow, shattering his skull, and listened to his boasting, and then asked him, "How can you pretend to prescribe for others the cure to all diseases when you are unable to cure yourself of your own manifest arrogance and foolishness?" Wow. Okay, I get the point. These are like some proverbs, basically. Cobra says, smaller games I try for 100%, but doesn't bother me if I don't get it. But Bethesda games, I just go until I get the feeling. Absolutely. Oh, definitely. Yeah. Let's see. Revan is on a new planet called M478, full of droids. HK-47 quest. Nice. A lot more that was cut from the game. So, Bowman, you play KOTOR 2, get the cut content mod. Got it. Also, by the way, you get the M478 separate from the other cut content. We'll have to download two things. Okay. Oh, totally. Is it on Steam? Because, I mean, I'm sure I can get it somewhere else, but I will definitely add it to my queue. I'm taking this book with me, because that is a cool book. You know what breaks my immersion a little bit? And I know it would be game-breaking if they didn't have this, but like in Skyrim, too, like these, like, who tends these fires? I know, nitpicky. KOTOR 1 and 2 are on Steam. Awesome. Okay, ready? We're gonna open the mysterious door. Winter sale, get them for $2.50. Yeah, no, I will. Oh my god. Bone Walker. What? Oh, he's casting, like encumbrance on me. I'm trying to think of what it is. The opposite of feather. So this is where strong feather would theoretically come in handy, right? Okay, let's just do my longbow. Don't worry, I got this, you guys. Yep, I got it. Bonewalker's damage attributes. Okay. Yeah, I would probably get the mods from Nexus. That's what I use for my modding. Let me get my bound longbow. Ready? There we go. Just had to be ready for it. Petty soul gem. For the longest time, I thought those were pretty soul gems, but they're petty. Thirty-six Lessons of Vivek, Sermon 15. Wow. Oh, I gained knowledge from the book. Unarmored. Oh, hooray. Wow. Chim. I know a little bit about Chim. The temporal myth is a man. Cobra, would you like to explain Chim to the viewers? Livestream KOTOR 2? You want me to livestream KOTOR 2? That's another question I had. like, I want to do a second game, and I was going to do Old Republic. And, you know, mainly for the story. Oh, there's my skull I need. Great. And there's an enchanted... Something's behind me. Oh, there's an enchanted dagger. Maybe I could do KOTOR 2 instead. This is gonna... Wait, Dagger of Judgment? Damage, Endurance, Damage, Strength, but the value's only 6. I'm gonna pass. Oh, that's... Yeah, I need that. I'm gonna be over-encumbered here. And yeah, 210. Scroll of Elemental Burst Fire. Chim is pretty much a spell that brings the caster to a godlike status. Do KOTOR 2 instead of Old Republic? Okay. I paid for a sub, so I'm going to be doing some Old Republic, you know, for the next month or so. But, yeah. KOTOR 2 sounds good. If you mess up, you're blank from... Yeah, I thought Chim was more than that. I'm over-encumbered, obviously. Just get rid of some crap that I don't need. Silver dagger. That dwarven spear is great. Yeah, I gotta sell so much stuff when I get back. Oh, you know what I'm gonna do? I'm gonna repair my armor. Probably use up a couple of hammers. Exactly. Okay, that's what I'm talking about. Yeah, right. The two people who ever achieved Chim, like, yeah, it's something that you need to, and then you almost, like, transcend, everything we know. It's almost like reading an Elder Scroll, right? Yeah. You almost, like, exist in, like, the past and the present and everything. And the future all at the same time. Great. I read something about Chim one time. It was this essay. And at the end, like, my mind hurt. It was really, 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 like Cobras is, very philosophical and very, very deep. Okay, yeah, did you see that? That fixed my encumbrance problem. And all my armor is now perfectly maintained. And I can pick up the 36 Lessons of Vivek for 200, I want to call them Drakes? I don't want to call them Septums, because I don't like Septum. Let's get out of here. Ah, Revan, you are describing the bootstrap paradox. If I go back in time and kill my great-grandfather, well, then I was never born, which means I never could have gone back in time. But that is not how time travel works. Somebody ask me how time travel works. Come on, somebody ask me. That was a book. Multiverse theory, right? I think I already opened that. Yeah, I did. All right, let's get out of here. I actually do believe in the multiverse. That anything that, like, could ever happen is happening right now. And has happened. And will happen. You know, there's infinite realities where I was never born. And there's infinite realities where, you know... I just had, like, a different sandwich for lunch today than the one I had. Like, I had a turkey sandwich for lunch, but there's a reality where I got ham instead. Really mundane stuff like that. Violet something. Fire salts. Yep. And there's another skull. Can't take that one. Another example is if Fry goes back in time because he had to become his own grandfather. A lesson in preserving the time stream from Mr. I'm My Own Grandpa. Good news, everyone! You want to hear my Zoidberg? Somebody asked me to do my Zoidberg. If I never turned into a Sith, I never split into dark and light. That crap. Exactly. Exactly, Revan. Oh, crap. Damn! Okay. Hold on. Cobra, you know what? Before I get killed by the skeleton archer because I was being careless, I do... What? Zoidberg? Young lady, get me a sandwich from the dumpster. That's all I got. I can't spit gold all the time. I'm gonna let her handle this. It's like if I just backed away slowly. See, I helped. Okay. You could kick Darth Vader and Kylo Ren's ass. I think anyone could kick Kylo Ren's ass. If Finn could kick his ass, you know? We didn't talk about this particular part of Force Awakens, the dumbest part of Force Awakens. Okay? The part that kind of like, when I was in the movie in the back of my mind, I'm like, oh, this is stupid. But then like when it actually happened, and again, 8 and 9 might clear it up, okay? I'll give them that. 8 and 9 might have it make more sense. But the thing with the map, do I have to say anymore? Like the whole movie is based around this map, and they've got to go find Luke. And, you know, R2 has a piece of the map, and it just happens to fit. They have the whole map, and then there's this piece that just is, it's like, I don't know. Wow, this is much bigger than I thought it was. Okay, I've got the skull, right? Should I leave, or should I go and see what's down there? R2-D2 was being a little... Yeah, well, no, he really was. He really was. I mean, you know, and then he wakes up at just the right plot moment. And, you know, I know, you definitely could have said that, like, you know, the Force was reawakening. It's the name of the movie, and maybe R2 felt it, which is why he woke up at that precise moment. But just, like, you know, haven't they mapped most of, like, the known galaxy? How did they not know where Luke was? I would have rather seen the movie where it starts with Luke with his Jedi Order, and that movie is about how he was betrayed and went into exile. That would have been the movie that I wanted to see. And then part 8 could have been like, you know, 10 years later, and, you know, whatever. I mean, maybe they do that as one of the standalone movies. Help? You're back? What's the matter, Baggables? What's that, Cobra? You want more Zoidberg? The president is choking on my gas bladder. What an honor. Yeah, they did screw up the cannon. Do I look good in the Dark Brotherhood armor with the star skirt? Hell. All right, so I've got the skull. I really wish this is a problem I have with Morrowind. It said, did it say journal updated? I guess maybe it didn't. I found the skull. An errand. Yeah, what's the errand? The errand is very similar to find. Yeah, so I found the skull. It's just, it doesn't, like, it didn't update when I found it. You know what I mean? I wish it said here, I found the skull in the cave. Now, anyways, I've got to go. I'm actually going to go to Pelagiad and see if I can catch a free trip from the Mage's Guild back to Balmora, because that's kind of a long walk. Let's play with our new strong feather spell, too, while I'm walking. Gotta be top of your game playing Morrowind. You're damn right, Cobra. You're damn right. No Mage's Guild in Pledge? Damn it! I'm gonna go find a merchant anyway to sell some of this stuff. I love in Tor when you go to a merchant, it just says sell junk. I think it did that in Warcraft too, World of Warcraft, but I like this. Just sell junk. You don't gotta go through each thing, you know? Walking to Sedanine, taking the Silt Strider. Good call. I am close to Sedanine. Let's see. Probably just look for the sign outside the door. Yeah, here we go. Supplies. I like to go to the, like, supplies person last. And sell whatever I couldn't sell at the other locations. Hello, guard.
Let's get this over with quickly.
Just a regular citizen. Archer, check this guy out.
I could kill that Gwar. Those boots are ruined.
How are you doing, Uller Nil? Let's see. Barter. Okay. Oh no, he's an armor. He's gonna buy weapons, so. Let's see. Silver dagger, I've got two. I don't need two. So the fire blade is a short blade. It does obviously fire damage 1 to 25, which is cool. I'm assuming I can recharge it with soul gems, right? So 5 to 7, 5 to 7, 6 to 9. But this one does 8 to 11, 7 to 12. 8 to 11 damage, but then that's got that fire damage on it. I don't want to carry around, you know, so many. Okay, so there's my silver dagger. That's got 389, 45, 45, 45. Same thing. So I'll sell the used one, and I will sell him. Oh, that dwarven spear. I'll never use that. That's great. Revan's fleet is under attack. Oh, Cobra, you gotta go? Work early tomorrow, man. Thanks for checking out the stream, though. It's good to see you. I'll be doing some, you know, plenty of Morrowind. We'll be doing a little bit of Tor, you know. But I think streaming KOTOR 2 is a really good idea. I guess I don't need the silver dagger, do I? I'll keep the fireblade to fight ghosts. Wait, I'll just sell that too. It's fine. And I'm going to sell these extravagant. Oh, he doesn't buy the pants. Bone mold helm I'll never use. Great, thanks. And let's go up one. That was one of Cobra's pro tips. Go up one or two gold. And then offer. And that's going to improve my speechcraft. Or probably my mercantile. Whatever it is. Probably speechcraft. Pelagiad. The Empire built a little fort here to guard the roads between Vivec, Sedanine, Balmora, and points north. And then some veterans took their mustering out pay and built themselves some little farms here. And pretty soon there's a few shops, a trade house. It's a pleasant little village. If you didn't know better, you'd think you were in Daggerfall or some other high rock town. I am... it's no secret that I've done some Skyrim roleplay in a couple different groups, and there was a person, his character name was Vorm, and he played a Imperial, like a Legion veteran, and he did exactly that. That was his backstory, was that he, you know, was tired after the Great War. It was like, you know, 4th Era 201. He was tired after the Great War, and he built himself, you know, a little house near an abandoned fort, and then slowly he had people kind of come and trade with him, and then he built a little farm, and it expanded, and he got tenants, and it expanded, and eventually he was the master of this large town. The trader, is there a magic shop? What's this? Is this the inn? The tavern. I might go into that tavern and see what's going on in there. This person is added by that Morrowind Comes Alive mod. I'm 95% sure. He's playing the Morrowind theme song. That's funny. I love how every shopkeeper has their own like personal guard. I don't believe I've seen a dark elf with such a grand outfit in some time. Hmm. Yes, you can help me. Let's see. Let's barter. Let's just sell some of this crap. Extravagant pants. Grief. Won't be using that anytime soon. Though, that vintage brandy. Yeah, let's get rid of that. Fire shield, I probably won't use. Scroll of Elemental Burst, fire. I don't really use scrolls. Scrolls of Vitality. Well, I lied. I might use a Scroll of Vitality. That could get me out of a jam, huh? Ash Salt, Ectoplasm, Fire Salt, Ghoul Heart. Is there any way to display books? I might keep these books for right now to read them later. The 36 Lessons of Vivek. Homilies of Blessed Almalexi. I read that. Let's see. On Morrowind. Have I read that? Let's see. Oh, I don't know if anybody knows this, Propylon Index, I guess. That's a large-scale quest where you actually set up these, like, way stations. It was kind of like the KOTOR 2 cutting room floor stuff. It was cut from... It was in the original game, but then they cut it, and then Bethesda actually released it on the wiki that you can... Can I stream KOTOR 2 tomorrow? Well, Christ, Revan, how much is it on Steam? I don't get paid till Friday. Ugh. Let's see. I gotta give that skull back to the person. If it's like $10, I'll go get it. If it's like $29.95, I'm gonna just wait a little bit. Do I have more coins I'm gonna sell? War of the First Council. Yeah, I've read that one. I'm just trying to get rid of some of the stuff that's kind of weighing me down. I suppose the 20 hammers is not helping. She's like, do I really need 20 hammers? Okay, cool. Let's go up a couple. Oh, he only has 449 gold. I sold him way too much stuff. Okay. What was the thing that I... The expensive thing I sold him? The brandy. Yeah. I'll sell that to someone else. I know, right, Bagables? I gotta stream KOTOR 2 tomorrow. I gotta make thumbnails. I gotta make graphics. I gotta make an overlay. No, it's possible. It's definitely possible. I would like to. Okay, it's $10 on Steam. That's reasonable. No problem. I realize this is the less exciting part of the video. For that, I apologize. Here we go. Boom. Great. Goodbye. All done. So to Sedanine, and then to Balmora. Sedanine. So just go southeast from here. Yeah. It's going to be great to go back to Sedanine. That's where it all began. That's where it all started. It's like going back to Riverwood in Skyrim, right? Whenever I have a fondness for Riverwood, it's just because it's the first town I ever saw. I remember the first time I played Skyrim, seeing Whiterun for the first time. I was just like, wow, Whiterun. So cool. And you know, it is a cool town. It's, for a lot of people, it's their favorite town. My favorite town is Solitude. I love Solitude. But I remember whenever I go back to Riverwood, I still get that feeling the very first time that Hadvar, because I didn't follow, what's his face, the Stormcloak. When Hadvar brought me there for the first time, he brought me to his uncle's shop. See, I thought I found like a super secret shortcut to Sedanine, but I didn't. Ugh, I'll just stay on the road. I just noticed the textures on this path. I mean, they're not... They look about like 1K maybe, but they're not terrible. I like how the grass is growing kind of between. That's all part of the texture, but then like they've got the plants that are growing up out of the stone. I do like that. I gotta turn this way at some point. I'm going the complete wrong way to get to Sedanine. Sedanine, Sedanine, not a single sardine. Here we go. Here we go. This is going to be so great. I feel like Bilbo Baggins returning at the end of Battle of the Five Armies, returning to Hobbiton. And he's like a king now. He's got all like the best. He's got the mithril shirt, and he's got the elven blade, and he's got like just like trunks full of gold and stuff. When I left here, I didn't know anything about Morrowind, and now I know one or two things. And I will take the Siltstrider. I badly want a mod that makes an animated Siltstrider. Right now in the story baggables, I have... Okay, so basically, I was arrested for something and put on that prison ship. Do you want to go back that far? And the Emperor himself, Uriel Septim, I'm pretty sure the 7th, he released me because I have some great destiny. So he let me go. So I arrived in Morrowind.
What's strange?
And basically, I met what's-his-face at the tax and excise office. This is not the answer you wanted, is it? Anyway, so he sent me to Caius Cassay in Balmora. Caius Cassay said, hey, you've got to make a name for yourself, okay? He says, I know, you know, he's basically a member of the Blades, or a former member of the Blades. And he said, you know, you've got to make a name for yourself. So go join some guilds, go do some quests, like, you know, just... Try to get to know the land a little bit, and I'm going to be getting, you know, like things in order for you. So I did that, went back to see him, and he says, you've got to learn about the cult of the Nerevarine and about the sixth house of Dagoth. And right now, I have found a skull that's going to allow me to go back, take the Siltstrider back to Balmora, and that orc, that female orc at the Mage's Guild is going to tell me something about the cult of the Nerevarine.
I only have a few.
That's where we're at. I've been paying some attention. Yeah, this is the trade house I want. Lock. I gotta unlock it. Oh, this is the back door. That's right. I still have Fargoth's ring, too. I could probably give that back to him at some point. Oh, he sells spells, too. I didn't know that. Fortify Luck. Sanctuary. Resist Magicka. Hearth Heal. I'll buy that just to mess around with it a little bit. Yeah, I don't use illusion or destruction or mysticism, actually. I probably should have taken mysticism. So all I wanted to sell him was these Dwemer coins and that brandy. There. Go up a couple. Offer. Done.
Yes, madame. What is it?
All right, to the Siltstrider. To the Batmobile! Was that a good answer, Bagables? Did I lose you? What happened? Where'd you go?
Special trip just for you. Same low price.
Well, thank you. Destination. Yep. Okay, travel. I gotta click travel and then Balmora. Great.
Why walk when you can ride?
Oh, the council club, yeah. All right. Oh, drunkard. Drunkards. Let me go to my local map. Let me get my bearings here. Okay, yeah, there we are. Guild's right there. I am very curious as to how this main story is actually going to unfold, though. Like, I know at some point I meet, you know, the three living gods. I can't wait for that. And if I have the right mods installed, at least Vivek should be fully voiced. And Dagoth Ur will be fully voiced, I think? I'm not sure. It definitely added voice acting. I keep forgetting to do a mod list. I'll do that tomorrow.
All right, I'm listening.
Sleep? Am I gonna have another horrible nightmare? Good. I keep like hoping I'll be level 3. I'm still level 2.
Speak freely, friend.
Ah, welcome.
Oh no. Ah, shoot. Not this guy. I gotta go see the orc in the Mage's Guild. My bad.
You want something?
My bad. Who was giving me quests here before?
It
was Ida's Fire Eye. Just curious. Any orders? No orders under the rank of protector. Okay, I gotta go to other Vivek City, Sandrith Mora, or Aldrun. Okay. Okay. So the Fighters Guild
you
is a dead
to
end.
Share your time with me, you humble.
All right, I'm listening.
For right now, it is a dead end.
May I help you?
Duties, yeah. No duties. Azira, yeah. Oh yeah, what do you have for spells, by the way? Oh, higher rank, I can buy spells from her. She probably has, like, the master spells. Uh, There you are. Okay, is this about the errand you're doing? Yes. Very good. I'll just take that skull from you. Perfect for what I have in mind. I don't want to know. Thank you. Now, as I promised, I'll answer your questions on the Nerevarine cult. Go ahead. Oh, here we go. Here we go. This Ashlander cult believes the long-dead hero Nerevar will be reborn to honor ancient promises to the tribes. According to legend, the prophesied Nerevarine will cast down the false gods of the Tribunal Temple, restore the traditional ancestor worship practiced by the Ashlanders, and drive all Outlanders from Morrowind. Both Temple and Empire outlaw the cult, but it persists among the Ashlanders who care little for Imperial or Temple law. Here, take this copy of my notes on the topic for Caius. Wow. That is cool. While I'm here, I'm going to see Ajira real quick and just make sure there's no duties for me.
I suppose I could spare a moment.
Yeah, pizza nips number two.
Welcome, friend.
Ajira knows that Sir Ithiel is good friend of Ajira. Look, 100 over 100 with him. That's cool.
I don't think I really need anything. Training? Conjuration, enchant, alchemy. No. Duties. Oh, okay. So I actually do have a quest. I've got to go to Edwina Elbert at the Guild of Mages in Aldrun. Okay, I'll get to that at some point. What is her name? Edwina? I'm wondering. There's no entry for her. Okay. Did you just purr at me?
This is an honor.
And I can't get out of the room. Yeah, this is great. So now what? Go back and see Caius. I could take the transport to Aldrun and continue that quest line, but I really want to go see Caius and continue the main quest line.
Is there something you need?
Miner's pick, common pants, common shirt. Caius Cassay.
Say your business.
Where'd everybody go? Chat died. Let's see. What is that anyway? It's Wednesday night. Yeah, I guess that's kind of an odd night. Wednesday night. Let me see. Caius could say he's right down here. I'm starting to get used to having a quest marker. I really am. Oh, war zones? Got it.
Please, by all means. I'm listening.
It's funny to me that, like, I know a couple of you guys are playing Tor, and I'm like, hey, I'll play Tor tonight. And it's like, no, play more. We want to watch you play Morrowind. Don't play Tor. But you're all playing Tor. I'm like, ah. I started a Togruta Consular last night on Harbinger. I really like the Togruta. You know, I really like Ahsoka Tano. Amazing character. So I wanted to play her race. Caius, I'm here to discuss my orders. Yes. And these are Sharn's notes on the Nerevarine cult. Excellent. I'm promoting you to Blade's Apprentice, Sir Ithiel. Wow. Let's have a drink to celebrate. Now, give me some time to think about how this fits in with the Emperor's plans for you. See, Baggables, this is the main, like, quest right here. The Emperor has plans for me, and Caius knows what they are. When I first met Caius, he was like, oh, I'm an old man. I don't know what you mean. And then I gave him the note from the Emperor, and he was like, oh, shit, I'm the Blade's agent. You're the new Blade. I'm like, okay. So take some time to polish your skills and enhance your cover story with a little freelance adventuring. Then when you're at the level of performance I want to see, I'll have new orders ready for you. Let's see if he's ready now. I've thought it over and I want you to interview... See, he is ready. I want you to interview three informants in Vivek City. I finally get to go to Vivek concerning the Nerevarine and then the sixth house. First, I want you to speak with Adaranrir, a Khajiit Thieves Guild operative. Second, I want you to speak with Bob, an Argonian in the Morag Tong. Oh, damn. Finally, I want you to speak with Mara Milo, a temple priestess. Here, I've written the details down so you won't forget, and here are 200 drakes for bribes and other expenses. That's your per diem. Okay, what can he train me in again? Yeah, speechcraft is good, but I think I'm good for right now. 88 over 100. He likes me. I wonder if I admire him. Oh, it went way down. Sorry, we're cool. Well, let me ask him about my dreams. You're worrying me, Cerethiel. You're not going loopy on me, are you? A word of advice. In Morrowind, if you have disturbing dreams, the temple says you're crazy, and they want to lock you up. And if you have disturbing dreams and think they mean something, then the temple thinks you're a prophet or witch, and they want to lock you up. So take my advice and keep a lid on it. The worst character in Morrowind. Bob. Hi, dear. I'm Bob. One of the things, well, this is interesting. Thieves Guild. In the rest of the Empire, the Thieves Guild is a more or less organized group of local criminal syndicates governing illegal trade in their communities. Here in Morrowind, the Thieves Guild is the newcomer. The established local crime lords are called the Kimona Tong. The Thieves Guild, I wonder what Tong translates to, because there's obviously the Morag Tong as well. Maybe guild. The Thieves Guild doesn't advertise, partly to avoid the law and partly to avoid the Kimona Tong, who have sworn to destroy the upstart Thieves Guild. Sugarlips Abasi over at the South Wall is a local guild boss. Right. Cool. So I have a lot to keep me busy now, actually. If I come here to options, these are my quests. So the Dark Brotherhood attacked me. A guard told me that the attackers were members of the Dark Brotherhood. He suggests that. Okay, so next time I'm in Ebonheart, I can follow up on that. Fargoth's hiding place. House Lalu. I'll save that for later. I can't start that. Oh, yeah. Larry Vary. We can't do that without Cobra, though. We promised him. Okay. Cloud Cleaver. I haven't seen the Naked Nord in a while. I wonder what happened to him. Sleepers Awake. Yeah, that's not really even a quest. Beauty and the Bandit. Oh, yeah. Oh, shoot. I was just in Pelagia, too. I could take the Silt Strider there. I could do that one in Pelagia. And I need... Okay, Vivek Informants. That's my main quest line right there. I gotta get to Vivek. First, I want to do a couple of these things. So, Sugarlips Habasi told me that New Shoes Bragger was caught by the guards in Pelagiad, Fort Pelagiad. Okay. So, do I need to go to Pelagiad? I should steal a Dwemer artifact from Mabistine Ensei and show it to Shadback Grob Burbug. Let's just rewrite that. I should steal a Dwemer artifact from Ricky and show it to Bob. And that'll do it. Let's see. Sure looks about you doing the new shoes, Bragor. That's the thing this is the part I don't fully understand here. Sugarlips Habasi told me that New Shoes Bragger was caught by the guards in Pelagiad and is being held in Fort Pelagiad. So we want New Shoes Bragger released. So Habasi heard that Mebistine Enek is secretly smuggling Dwemer materials and that Shadback Grob Burbug, a guard in Fort Pelagiad, has been taking bribes to overlook the smuggling. I should steal a Dwemer artifact. So I've got to go to, why don't I go to Pelagiad? And I will deal with those two quests. Goodbye, shirtless Caius Cassette. I'm going to go do that right now. I'm going to go to the Silt Strider and do that right now. I should rest and meditate on what I've learned. Uh-oh, guys. Am I going to be level 3? The leveling in this game is so slow. But, I mean, it's all good. You just really feel like you've earned a level. Is that a bowl? I better not if I steal that bowl, I'm going to get shot in the face.
We make a special trip just for you. Same low pride.
I can't get to Pelagia. I guess I'll go to Sedanine then.
We make a special trip just for you. Same low price.
This way, I'm pretty sure. Let's go to the world map. Yeah, Pelagia. I hate to be that guy, but let me just... I gotta check something real quick here. Nexus over on YouTube, if you want to check... the chat is moved over to Twitch. Okay, we still have a... I thought all the viewers up. I was gonna say I'm not gonna... I had a kind of an interesting thought, but I didn't know if the stream was still healthy. Let me get my chat back. There it is. All right. I'm going to do those two quests in Pelagia, and I think I'll call it a night after that. Is that where the people are? Well, I'm dual streaming to YouTube as well. But I have a note on YouTube that the chat has moved to Twitch, but still a couple people will chat me on YouTube, which is totally cool. I appreciate the interaction. I can't monitor both at once. I was going to actually, like, try stream to Hitbox as well, but, like, you know. I don't know if that's really necessary. What I was going to say is that because I'm now a Blades agent, that really, like, makes me feel conflicted because I hate the Blades. One of the things that I incorporate into my... where's that strong feather spell? Yeah. Into my Altmer roleplay is that particular character... That particular character served in the Great War, and he was like a Vicereve, and he served in the Great War, and, well, one instance of him anyway did. And the point of the story is that he remembers when the Thalmor ambassador brought the heads of all the Blades agents in the Elmeri Dominion in Somerset and Valenwood to... the throne room, basically, as a way of saying, you know, we reject. I'm trying to think if that was before or after Titus Mead II rejected the first peace treaty by the Dominion. I think that was actually part of the declaration of war when they killed all the Blaze agents. My thoughts on the Starforge? I mean, I got to agree with Spectre that... if it went, you know, if it was toe-to-toe against the first or the second Death Star, I mean, my money's on the Starforge. What do you think, Revan? Spectre Studios, you still there? I know he was at work. He may not be there anymore. He was telling me that he found a good place that will deliver, like, whatever food he wants to where he works, so he's not limited to just pizza anymore. Okay, let's do a quick save. And by quick save, I mean a normal save quickly, not an actual quick save. And let's check our journal. So who am I looking for? I'm looking for that bandit. And then, oh, jeez. And then I'm looking for this whole thing here. No, wait. Options. Okay, yeah, Beauty and the Bandit. Let's do this one first. Nelos Onmar. Okay. Nelos Onmar. I really hope I didn't sell that glove. I may have sold her glove. I forgot in this game it lets you send... it lets you sell, you know, like, important quest things. I think I sold it. I'm pretty sure I sold it. Starforge. It makes the ships every second. Yeah. Oh, yeah, absolutely.
Stay out of trouble and you won't get it.
I remember thinking, like, where did I find this lady's glove? Damn it. I have no idea where I put that glove either.
I thought I heard something.
A lot of people in this tavern, huh?
What was that?
There he is.
I'm listening.
Am I standing on this table or was my eye? Happy to help you, stranger. I'm Nelos Onmar. People are fairly friendly here in Pelagiad. We don't mind answering a few questions. Nelos Onmar. What little secret? Little advice? Crap. Oh, okay. The Breton is a trader, deals in a bit of everything. Okay, that's the person I need to go steal the Dwemer artifact from. Alright, I've got to try something really quick. I'll be right back. I just got to look something up. Okay, this might I'm about to do something that might crash the game. If it does, I will be right back.
I could kill that girl. Those boots are ruined.
Shoot. No, hold on. Here we go. So the issue I'm having is I think I sold that glove and I'm trying to use a console command to put it back in my inventory. Citadel 12, how are you? The guy is streaming Morrowind. Oh, you asking Revan what he's on about? Yeah, Revan likes Star Wars. He didn't like Star Wars. He lived it. He is Dark Side Darth Revan. That's just who he is. Extravagant. Extravagant. Yeah. _ glove _ left. I have no idea if this is going to work. This may very well crash the game. If it does, you know, what are you going to do? I've had very little luck with console commands. Like, in general. Okay, I want one of those. Here we go. Did it work? Look at that, it worked! Citadel 12, I don't know if we've met. Thank you so much for watching. I appreciate it. Usually we're a little more action-packed. I just got a little, tied up trying to get that glove, so let's see if this works now. There it is. Great. Now, I want to just say, too, I don't normally do things like that, you know, use a console command to kind of, like, cheat my way through a quest. It's just that I think I accidentally sold that glove, and I have no idea. So, like, who I sold it to. So the two options were, three options. I abandon the quest, I use a console command to cheat, or, you know, we spend the next 2 hours while I go to every single trader and look and see if they have it and figure out which one it was. You have what? How odd. She was a lovely young woman, but what would she want with a rogue like me? She is beautiful, though, and seems sweet. For the first time in my life, I actually felt a little remorse for robbing someone. I should see her again. Here, take this. Tell her you have a note from Nellos. I must see her again. I won't forget this friend. Very interesting. Okay, I will. I now have the note from Nellos. Now remind me, Bagables, remind me not to sell the note from Nellos. You know I'm going to sell it. Okay, now if I started using console commands to give myself, you know, the best armor in the game or whatever, I mean, that'd be more questionable, I think. You can't sit on the bar stool too, which is unfortunate. Yes, stranger? Oh, she's a companion.
This better be important.
What, Yaka? Me? Speak, Ashland. Not speak so good, old elf. Sorry. I just love that name. Yakum Hershashishi. Revan was a good guy, but he eventually split a dark side Revan and a light side Revan. Now, obviously, that's to make it canon, like, whatever, like, however the story ends up. I mean, that's a clever way to make, you know, to make the ending of the game canon, right? Whichever way it goes. Now I've got to go to the trade house, which I think is right here. No, this is the armorer, right? No, this is where I need to go. I need to steal a Dwemer or something from this person. Oh, how am I supposed to do that? Let's see. Options? Right. Thieves Guild. I gotta get this one done. Right. Yeah, I thought that was really clever. Because if, like, in lore, if Revan just went full dark side and was Darth Revan, then, you know, the people who didn't go that path would have felt kind of cheated. An interesting game like that is actually Warcraft 2 Tides of Darkness, which I just finished today, part 7 of my Let's Play on my YouTube channel. Shameless plug. Nobody cares about that series, though, for some reason. But I know why. It's a 20-year-old game. But you can play as the Alliance or you can play as the Orcs, and both of them have their complete, you know, own story and their own ending. But obviously when they went to make Warcraft 3, they had to make one canon and one not, and it was clever the way they did it. They made the Orc story, the whole Orc campaign, canon, except at the very end when they came to Stormwind Castle, they weren't able to take it. They had a siege on it, and at the end, the humans rallied to fight back. So it's really interesting how the entire Orc campaign is official canon, and, well, you get the idea. Except for that last bit, the Orcs didn't crush the last of the humans and take over all of Lordaeron. Okay, so this is where I want, like, a quest marker. Okay, let's see. Habasi heard that Mebistine Ensei, the person I'm standing in front of, is smuggling Dwemer materials, and that a guard is taking bribes. I should steal a Dwemer artifact, show it to the guard, and demand he be released. Steal a Dwemer artifact. Okay, so this calls for a save. I could see this going really poorly. Citadel, do I remember you from the other night, or is this your first time checking out the stream? Dwemer, no, Pewter. I thought I said Dwemer. Pewter Goblet. I'm getting tired, that's what it is.
There's someone watching me. I can tell.
If I can go upstairs, maybe there's something up here I can just steal. That would be great. There's something Dwemer up here. The light side me is almost always annoying me. Well, thanks, Citadel. I'm glad you found me. Yeah, I really appreciate it. This is my first time playing through Morrowind. I'm a huge fan. I played Oblivion, you know, 100 times like everybody. And I run a, you know, moderately well-received Skyrim roleplay on YouTube. And I really just wanted to play Morrowind, but I didn't have it in me to do, like, a full roleplay of Morrowind. First of all, it'd be a really hard game to roleplay because of the lack of voice acting. And, you know, I just, with, like, personal time, making one episode of my Skyrim series takes, like, 5 hours for a 45-minute episode. And I knew, like, Morrowind would be at least 100 parts. So I didn't want to spend the next 2 years doing it. I wanted to just enjoy the game a little bit more. And I love the interaction with you guys. I've learned so much about the game and you know, a lot about the lore. And I appreciate you checking it out. So let's see. Anything Dwemer up here I can steal? If not, I'm going to have to go try to pickpocket him. Wooden bucket, small chest. Anybody up here? Lock level 50. Right, yeah, my chat the other night, it got, like, a little wild, and somebody was joking around that we should make Baggables just a mod, and I said, just in case, you know, it got real, you know, anybody started, you know, arguing about something, you know, like religion, politics, anything like that, I said, I just want to make sure I don't miss anything, and anyone gets upset. Let's see. I have this, that's open door. I think that's gonna work on a chest, though. Oh, it did work. Son of a bitch. Darth Revan, you know, see the issue is, Revan, you're part of the problem. No, I'm just totally kidding. Data Shimura, I do not... The BF1 beta? I have not played that. Dwemer, look at that. Perfect. Exactly what I needed. Who's gone offline? Revan? Isn't Revan on a cruise ship? rusted chest. Oh, soul trap, that's cool. But yeah, that's how it got started, Citadel. I just said to myself, you know, I'd rather not, you know, spend the next 2 to 3 years playing Morrowind. I want to experience the story now. Like, I want to know the lore. I want to have, you know, fun playing. I want to play it a few times, you know, and get better and better, and experience more. And I thought the best way to do that would probably be on Twitch. Let's see. I don't think I actually read that book I just picked up. There you go. There you are, Revan. You're on a ship, right? You said. Stuck behind this table. As you can tell, Citadel, I've got it pretty heavily modded. I did the overhaul and the, you know, better bodies and let's see. The pilgrim must visit each of the shrines of the seven graces. At each site, the pilgrim must stand before the three-sided stone triolith and read the inscription. To ease the pilgrim's task, the temple has made a list of shrines along with directions and advice to pilgrims. The blessings of each shrine last at least half a day. Very interesting. Okay, here Lord Vivek met a poor farmer whose guar had died. Yeah, right. The farmer could not harvest his muck without his guar. Well, God forbid you not harvest your muck. And he could not provide for his family or his village. So the Lord Vivek removed his fine clothes and toiled in the fields like a beast of burden until the crop was harvested. It is at the fields of Kumu we go to pray for the same humility Lord Vivek showed on that day. Cool. I'm going to take this book. I like it. Well, I'm trying to remember the other night. I think Bagables volunteered.
Let's
be honest. Our chat is pretty tame. Not a lot of troublemakers. Well, sir, thank you so much for letting me look around your shop. I'm sure you won't have any trouble with the law in the near future. Bye. Wait, where's the door? Is this not the door? There's the door. So now I've got to go find that particular guard. Now let me go to my quest journal. Thieves Guild, here we go. Show it to, okay, I got to go find the guard named Shadback Grob Burbug. Shadback Grob Burbug. How hard is it going to be to find a an orc guard? See, that's a Nord. If they look like they're from the show Vikings, it's a Nord. If it looks like Ragnar Lothbrok.
Come on, I haven't got all day, you know.
I'm not seeing anything about dropped frames. You're having some issues, Bagables? I'd be afraid to ask Revan, because, again, he's on a cruise ship with limited internet. I have not adjusted my settings at all.
I only have a few moments.
Can I ask him about a specific person? Guards keep the peace, chase down criminals. Let's see. Blades. I've never heard the Blades described as the Emperor's spies before. That's interesting.
Yes, madame. What is it?
The sixth house. The sleeping house. House Dagoth. The house of Lord Dagoth, the true house, the one house to welcome all true Dunmer and drive the Enwa from our land. Rejoice and join us. Come to Red Mountain and prepare the way for his coming. If I was going to try to, like, RP this at all, I would definitely go in for the sixth house and the cult of the Nerevarine, because I'm a Dunmer. So I just, like, the decision I would make based on what I know about the lore would be obviously to reject the Imperial Pantheon and follow my people. It's annoying to tell who's who. Yeah, I know, but there's one, like, I'm looking for one that's an orc. So you wouldn't think that would be too tough? What am I stuck on, a rock? Let's see. I like the look of Pelagia, though. It's really great how it's like an old imperial fort, and they just built a town around it. I really like that.
Come on, then. Say something or move on. Stay out of trouble and you won't get hurt.
Guard tower. I probably can't go in there. The armorer. Jeez, I mean, he could be in the armorer. This is where, like, I want to go to the wiki, but I don't want to do it yet.
I haven't got all day, you know.
I think I might get lucky.
Any time now.
This one guard who is corrupt. Fort Pelagia. Maybe, I think he might be in Fort Pelagia, now that I think about it. You know what I want to do as well, like, when I'm done with this? I mean, I might do another playthrough where it's much quicker and I'll try to find things I missed the first time I play as another race. But I really want to do... Oh, is this my person? It is. Shadbach Grab Burbug. Found him. Or...
Do not waste my time.
Her, of course. That looks like a Nausicaan from Star Trek The Next Generation. But anyways, I would like to try my hand at Daggerfall.
That?
I'm not saying I'm going to finish it, but I'd like to try it. Bagables, you all right? Is the stream okay for you? I don't believe I've seen a dark elf with such a grand outfit in some time. Can I help you? Yes. What does she sell? Oh, she sells armor. Any light armor that I can make you? I haven't got any new light armor in a while, actually. Yeah, she probably wouldn't have it. Yeah, it's really not good looking. Really? It keeps dropping baggables? Let me very quickly just check my end to see what it says about, like, drop frames or whatever. Yeah, it's according to OBS, I'm okay. I've dropped a couple frames, but I don't know. I'm having trouble getting the stream. I just went to my own channel. I'm having trouble getting the stream started myself. Huh. Well, at any rate, I'll just finish this. Let's see. New shoes, Bragger. Where did you get that Dwemer artifact? I'll bet you stole it. Huh. How did you know Magbestine had one? Because Magbestine pays me good money to keep it sit. let New Shoes go and I'll forget about it. Okay, you got me this time. I'll let him go. But it's not over between us, Cerethiel. I'll remember you. Oh, boy. Goodbye. Huh. She's not happy. Go ahead and save. So I don't know what's going on with the stream. It's getting late for me anyway. Thank you very much for watching. I think we got a good amount. What is this guy doing? We got a good amount done in the main story tonight. And if the stream died and no one's seeing this, I'll go back to a previous save and we will give Shad back Grau Burbug, that Dwemer artifact, again. Let's see. Revan, Bagable, Citadel, whoever else is still watching, have a very good night. Thank you very much for watching, and we'll be back soon with more Morrowind. And then we're going to actually go to Vivec City. Next time, we're going to go to Vivec City, and we're going to take care of the informants for Caius. Thanks very much. Have a good night. Wait, Revan, so you can... I'm back. Wait, you can see me, Revan? If so, I'm glad because it means that the stream didn't die and maybe it'll actually upload. That's all. He's reminding me about KOTOR 2 and the content mods tomorrow. I can make an effort to get that done. I was talking to Lancis about getting, like, what the second game for the channel should be. You know, something just to break up Morrowind a little bit. And I think KOTOR 2 is a really good, really, really good idea. Anyways, see you guys later.
Finally, something interesting.
You look like a great honor long enough.
Die, scoundrel. Come on!
Coward. Do not waste my time.